Getting off the junk removal truck is a dream that few junk removal business owners will ever achieve. It is also the first large milestone to hit on your path to building a business that runs without you. In this video, I'm going to show you what you need to do to get off the junk removal truck. Hey everyone, I'm Lee Godbold with Junk Removal Authority, where we help junk removal business owners make more money and live a better life. I built up a 10 plus truck operation in the first 6 years, and now we help hundreds of other junk removal business owners do the same. One of the most important things to grow your business and to get you off the truck is to add more trucks. I founded our sister company, Specialty Truck Bodies, to build the ultimate junk removal truck. We've got a purpose-built facility that constructs quality junk removal trucks and ships them throughout the country. To get more information on the junk removal truck that is setting the standard in the industry, click on the link in the description. Okay, so you've started this junk removal business and you've been growing. Now you're ready to take the big step onto phasing yourself off of the truck. But how exactly do you do that? First off, when should you do it? Unlike many franchise systems, the JRA way is when business owners, what we recommend anyway, is when business owners actually stay on the truck as long as possible. Once your truck is averaging about 15 to 20 jobs per week, you should start this process, this phasing out process, because you should be getting a second truck pretty soon. Step one, you need to train 2 team members to quote jobs and drive the truck. Start out by getting their opinion on job amounts before presenting to customers. So you guys do the walk around, you take a look at everything, you guys kind of get to the side, you say, hey, what do you think about this? They give you a price, you go back and forth, you say, yeah, that's it or not. You kind of get them calibrated and then you go present it to the customer. Then you want to test them out by you actually being the navigator and them running the entire show. After you've worked with them on 30 jobs or so, somewhere in that range, as them being the TL, you're probably going to be finding that they're doing a pretty daggone solid job. Step two, begin getting off the truck about halfway or so into the day. Don't all of a sudden get completely off the truck. You don't want to do this for a few reasons. One, you want to ease your team into this just a little at a time. Secondarily, you want to get used to the lower profit a little at a time. Do this consistently over a, say, 2-week time frame, then start giving them some full days, again, a little at a time. Step three, now it's time to get a second truck. Now things are getting kind of fun. They're getting entertaining. You're getting really jacked up when you get that second truck. At this point, you'll find you'll be on some jobs, you yourself will be on some jobs, and you'll have crews doing other jobs. Over time, as the second truck gets busier, you'll want to have a total of about 5 people, of which 3 need to be able to drive and quote. Step four, let's raise up your advertising spend. You need to make sure you are maxing out Google Ads or on the way to doing so. You should be doing SEO. You need to be on Home Advisor. You gotta be doing the Yelp. You gotta be doing some email campaigns, and you gotta be advertising in any other way that you found that actually brings in jobs. You might also run some Groupon offers just to keep your guys busy as you are building up this second route. You need to keep these trucks rolling. Volunteer your trucks if you have to. Keep them moving. Keep them out there. They're gonna be advertising for you going down the road. That's a big, giant moving billboard. It's important to understand that as you add trucks and you get off the truck, you're not going to be as profitable. Your profit is going to shrink. This is necessary and temporary, so don't let it surprise you. Step number 5, take a 5-day vacation. Once you've done this and things seem to have stabilized, you should take about a 5-day vacation. You'll still need to have your phone available, most likely at this time, but you're going to get a good gauge as to where you stand and how good your truck crews are at this point. Listen, that is all there is to getting off the truck. This wasn't a very long video. Get the emotion out of it. You guys are so emotional about your businesses, rightfully so, but you got to take the emotion out. The emotion is clouding your judgment. It's holding you back. Make a plan and stick to it. If you don't, then you'll wind up like most junk removal business owners, and you'll get stuck on the truck and you'll never truly build a great American business. A business that can make your dreams become reality and give you freedom in your life. A key piece to a smooth transition to a two-truck operation is a reliable junk removal truck. Jerry's sister company, Specialty Truck Bodies, uses a decade of knowledge and experiments to construct the ultimate junk removal truck. It has everything you need and is constructed with the best quality to make sure it earns you a ton of money for many years to come. Click the link in the description for more information. Again, I'm Lee Godbold with Junk Removal Authority, where we help junk removal business owners make more money and live a better life.